Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, he is the TWF.
Suck balls! Oh. Oh. Well, this Saturday is the day, people. July 17th, the event of the summer. It's called Revengeance at the Colonial Theater. The address there, you know this already. 3522 Stockton Boulevard, Sacktown, door 7, bell time 7:30.
Are you kidding me, Jacoby Jones? This is gonna be, I guarantee it, one of the hottest shows of the year. You gotta show up, folks. Why? Bang.
Well, someone has friends in high places. The Jake loses the number one contender match, but somehow, I don't know how, ends up in a title match this Saturday against Paulie Denali, a rematch from Real Mania when he got his head shaved.
Never question anything when it comes to the Jake. You know he's got something up his sleeve. Speaking of up the sleeves.
Wow. First time ever, one-on-one, Joey Balls and Ecstasy will duke it out this Saturday at the Colonial. You need to show up.
You're damn right. Joey Balls, Dick Pearsall, let me tell you something, Mr. Ecstasy. You are going to have your hat ass served to you.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Also on the card, Scorpion and Sick Case finally meet one-on-one after months and months and months of going back and forth. I can't wait.
This one is going to be crazy. I guarantee the first two rows of the audience are going to be covered in plastic just like a Gallagher contest because blood's going to fly.
Also, the flip side of that feud, Raz Rhino and Ron Rufio duke it out for the first time one-on-one since that crazy Samoan chain match back at Rio Mania, a night of grudge matches this Saturday, Revengeance.
It's going to be huge. All those Rufaholics are going to be going nuts.
It's time for the dugout. Not talking about the Oakland A's or San Francisco Giants dugout. It's time for Dick's dugout. Yes, my friends, there is animosity.
Cut the music. I'm pissed. I am pissed. Every month I come out, do my dugout. Well, this month, folks, it's personal. It's personal. That's right. Let me give you dirt heads a little bit of a history lesson. Yeah, I called you dirt heads. Back a few months, maybe a year ago, I got together with my man Joey Balls and we decided to put together the most elite faction that this federation's ever seen. The cream of the crop. And we came up with a $1 million militia. Joey Balls, Dick Pearsall, of course, managing, Scorpion, and Ecstasy. Well, Scorpion, or AKA Samsonite, because we carry that guy, just like any corporation, got cut. Now it's down to the three amigos, the elite. Well, last month, the $1 million militia got a shot at the belt. Ecstasy got a shot at the belt. So we decided it would be in our best interest if my man Joey Balls here helps out and makes sure that we go home with the gold. But you got jumped by Ecstasy. So in order to, just to quote my man Ricky Ricardo, Ecstasy, get out here. You got some splaining to do.
A lesson in history, people. At one time, a $1 million militia ruled this company. However, that man right there declared his independence.
Laugh it up. Cut his music. Laugh it up. It's a real big joke, isn't it? We got the belt. We decided that you need a little bit of help. And did you accept the help? No. And did you win the belt? No! You big-headed, egoistic jerk! We had a chance! We had a shot! We could have the gold, but you know what?
I had a shot! It was my shot! You were supposed to stay back there and watch me handle my business!
We decided...
That's what was supposed to happen! But no! But no! You wanted some of the fame! You wanted some of the glory! So you had to come out and help me! I did not need no help! Look at you two and look at me! You think I need you guys' help? I carried you! I carried you for a year and a half, you piece of shit! You know I have!
You didn't carry a shit, I carried you!
Who's won the gold? Since we were together, who has won the gold?
I had gold.
You can't win without me, and you fucking know it.
Let me just say this. Lessons have to be learned. Got it?
Oh, come on, wait a second. I can smell Pearl Harbor since this thing was started. Oh, it's Scorpion. Dick Pearsall is stuck in the ring as Scorpion chases out Joey Balls.
He really didn't mean to.
Joe K.O. Guess who wasn't about to take Dick Pearsall's verbal abuse for 1 second longer?
You think you can treat me that way? You think you can put your hands on me? Well, guess what, Junior? I'm still your manager. Yeah, that's right. So you got a little match coming up. Not against one, but against two. Yeah, that's right. I call it the lethal combination. Yeah, you've heard it before. Black Assassin and Lockjaw.
Oh no. Well, I guess this is part two of the ambush. Yes, it's Black Assassin and Lockjaw. There was not a typographical error on your screen. Dick Pearsall, I don't know if he greased the palms of Commissioner Bala Bala or what, with hundreds and fifties. The bottom line is, though, Ecstasy now must face two men in a handicap match. Two very large, very powerful. Yeah, guys with chips on their shoulders.
Oh, this is gonna be good, Jacoby Jones. You know what the old saying is, you mess with the bull, you get the horns. Well, Mr. Ecstasy, you got the horns. Both of them, Black Assassin and Lockjaw.
Well, Ecstasy has to do this. Ecstasy.
You're damn right, I'm still his manager, aren't I? I still sign the damn contracts, don't I?
Well, you painted him into a corner. Ecstasy oozing confidence, but you gotta think in the back of his mind, he knows he has to face two very strong...
Just like a four-year-old when he spills paint in the garage, you gotta teach him a lesson, and Ecstasy's about to have a lesson, a very rough lesson taught to him.
Well, talk about disrespect Dick Pearsall. Ecstasy spent his career making you money. He spent his career breaking his back, breaking his limbs, becoming champion and wrestler of the year of this company, and now this is how you treat a guy who just wants to branch out on his own?
Are you kidding me? I made this guy, took him from nothing and made him into something, and this is the way he repays me? Are you kidding me, Jacoby? I'm furious.
Well, Dick Pearsall, personally responsible for Ecstasy's dilemma here. Knee to the stomach early by Lockjaw, and this is what happens when you have to face two guys. Handicap matches are not the norm here in TWF. You're not going to see our champion versus seven guys every week like certain other promotions, but what you are going to see is sometimes someone like Ecstasy gets painted into a corner by a guy like Dick Pearsall.
He brought it on himself, Jacoby Jones. He should have listened to what I told him. He should have done exactly what Joey Balls was trying to help him do, but instead he turned on us.
Oh, look at Ecstasy. Motivation is the best damn thing in the world. Uh-oh.
Yeah, good luck motivating yourself against a 300-pounder.
Oh, and Ecstasy does not know the word quit. Ecstasy going after Lockjaw. Ecstasy, despite giving up maybe 100 pounds to Lockjaw, is going at him. Oh, and there's a reason Ecstasy was Wrestler of the Year for 2008. There's a reason he was world champion here in TWF for an excess of 7 months that year. Oh,
I'm going to say that reason was Dick Pearsall. What do you think of that?
Well, Lockjaw takes one low, and now Black Assassin, fresh as a daisy, being tagged into proceedings here.
Here we go.
You can see there's a woman and a man at ringside looking on. The woman is Tierra. The man, I don't even know his name.
More of Moro's clan, his clique, his mercenaries, whatever you want to call him.
Well, from what I'm told, Alex Morrow's contractual obligations to this tag team are up.
Oh.
They're free agents. Oh, kick to the stomach now. And you've got to think that earlier punishment by Lockjaw can only work in the favor of the Black Assassin in this contest. He's fresh, Ecstasy is not, and it's showing at this moment.
You're damn right, just soften up the next man. As soon as you get a little bit of a gain of advantage, tag out.
And stomps to the stomach now, choking him out on the corner. Very sound strategy by the Black Assassin. Very underrated is this guy. He can go in the squared circle. A very formidable tag team like him and Lockjaw. From what I'm being told, this weekend at Revengeance, they will get a tag title shot. So they could get some huge momentum with a win over Ecstasy here and facing whoever the tag team champions are.
I call this a little bit of a tune-up for him. Look at the strength.
Beautiful suplex. Nicely executed. The man is strong.
Hell yeah.
There's no doubt about it. He doesn't look like George Clooney, but he doesn't need to with a bad attitude and the ability that he possesses. Lockjaw has huge wins in his TWF career over big-time names like Michael Nothing, like The Jake.
Well, on any given day, just with Lockjaw's power and size, you know that he can get the 1-2-3 on pretty much anybody in this fed.
One thing about Lockjaw is he chokes out Ecstasy. He has not even reached his potential as far as I'm concerned. He could do so much more in TWF. There's a spinning toehold. That's like a Dory Funk in 1979 in Japan.
There you go. You just took the words right out of my mouth and you're dating yourself.
Oh, definitely. I don't know anyone else that does a spinning toehold unless your last name is Funk.
Damn right. Oh, how about that for a little bit of a moderation on that. Very nice.
We spoke of the tag titles briefly earlier. They will be on the line later tonight as Carney, Craig, and Steele finally get their rematch for those tag titles against Ashton and Ink. An epic main event here tonight on television.
That's going to be a good one.
But meanwhile, right now, Black Assassin locks in that figure four. It's time for the obligatory woo!
There you go. Well, the homework was obviously done by these two gentlemen working the lower extremities of Mr. Ecstasy. Uh-oh.
Nice reversal by Ecstasy. He knows that if his legs get taken out, that's 90% of his offense. He flies all over the ring. The guy's an extremely amazing athlete. Plus, it's hard to give an uber kick, a super kick, with one damn leg.
You're damn right. Well, here we go. Black Assassin back up to a vertical base. Let's see what he has in mind.
Well, definitely the first to his feet. And if you're scored on points, Ecstasy would probably be behind. But we don't do that in pro wrestling. Ecstasy, who last month did not go in cahoots with Ball of Ball, declared his own independence, didn't win the title, but won the respect and admiration of the TWF crowd.
He should have listened to one Dick Pearsall and done what best for the Million Dollar Militia. Oh, look at this. Oh,
beautiful move by Ecstasy. We just spoke about his amazing, unparalleled athleticism moments ago. Turns a double suplex into a DDT on both of his opponents. Drops them both on their skulls. Nicely done.
Oh, no.
Beautiful. Dives over the top rope onto both of his opponents. These people are digging it, and you know, for years, the people, it's been on the tip of their tongue about how talented Ecstasy was. He sometimes let his attitude get in the way, but now they respect and admire the heart and the skill of that guy.
Coming back with weapons.
Well, you gotta pull that out if you want to win a handicap match, and he knows that. Oh, DDT's the skull of Black Assassin onto that chair, but there you go. There's always that second man in this handicap situation, dude.
Just when you think you have an advantage, you look over your shoulder, and here comes a 300-pound bald dude to give you a little business.
Oh, Ecstasy, though, shakes off the trouble. Oh, but there you go. It's hard to get hit in the face by someone who's 320 pounds, but Ecstasy's, look at that.
Used a foreign object given by the Psycho fan, I think. Oh, no.
Oh, good God, what a super kick. He left himself open. He had a few steps of room, and boom, right in the damn jaw. Might have knocked him out and might have given Ecstasy an opening.
Holy crap.
Well, there's that flip over the top rope with the greatest of ease. He makes the hardest athletic feats. Oh, there's that DDT. Look easy.
Finishes off with a wow.
Amazing uber kick to the jaw.
Damn it.
And yes, Dick Pearsall, he's doing just fine on his own right now without your evil influence.
Hey, I'm saying the guy has...
Beautiful.
If he didn't have talent, I wouldn't have picked him to be in the Million Dollar Militia. We know he has talent. He's just got a few screws loose upstairs.
Well, every young athlete sometimes has to branch out and do his own thing. Has to grow as an athlete. Look at LeBron James.
Yeah, he can do his own thing as long as I tell him he can.
Oh, really?
Damn right. Oh, look at the strength. Oh,
wow, lifting a man who's much heavier than him. Nice Samoan drop there. However, oh, once again, that second man, that X factor in this contest is that third man. It's a handicap match. It's 2-on-1, and just when you put your efforts on one guy, the other guy makes you pay.
Enormous stomp.
And then a huge spine buster. Fantastic. By a very huge man.
Beautiful 1-2 combination pulled off by one Mr. Lockjaw.
Well, if Lockjaw and Black Assassin pull out a win here and injure Ecstasy going into his big match with Joey Balls this weekend, what, do they get some extra Ben Franklins from you and Joey Balls, Dick Pearsall? Is that how it works?
There are always little side stipulations on any contract, Jacoby Jones. You know that, so I'm just let's just say I'm rooting very heavily for these two gentlemen.
Incentives for broken bones?
Oh, yeah.
Incentives for injuries? Joey Balls could be getting a very injured Ecstasy when they lock horns this Saturday, July 17th at the Colonial Theater.
Not that he needs it. Joey Balls could beat Ecstasy on his worst day. Look at that.
Nice combination of moves there. Drives the shoulder, then hits the overhead belly to belly. Cover.
Two.
Oh, barely gets that left shoulder out, but the impact of facing two men continuously has got to be wearing on an athlete, even the caliber of Ecstasy. It's still 2-on-1.
You're damn right. No chance to rest for Ecstasy. Right now, Lockjaw's taking a little respite in the corner, letting Black Assassin do the work, but pretty soon, believe me, there'll be a tag off, and the fresh man will be in there working over Ecstasy.
Ecstasy, trying to clear the cobwebs, does not know that he's perched on the ropes at this moment in time.
What's he have in mind?
I don't know.
Double axe handle. Oh, no.
Wow. Beautiful flipping neck breaker. Nicely executed. Like I've said, Black Assassin might be the most underrated man on the roster. Oh, there's a rake to the eye to get out of trouble. But Black Assassin has all the tools. Look at that. Beautifully done. Has all the tools necessary to make an impact on this roster. He's been brainwashed by Alex Morrow for months. However, that might not be the case anymore.
Black Assassin impressing every single patron in this Colonial Theater and one Dick Pearson.
Oh, here we go. Oh, gut wrench suplex by a very powerful Lockjaw throws Ecstasy 16 feet across our wrestling ring.
Chucked him like a bale of hay.
And it might only be a matter of time. When you take this much punishment for this long, I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're the Incredible Hulk, Thor, or Spider-Man. You're going to go down.
You're damn right. And most importantly, there's a lesson being learned.
And here we go. Nothing fancy about that. That's just a 320-pound man choking the life out of a guy that's much smaller.
The strength in his hands must be amazing. Oh, look at that.
Oh, and Lockjaw took too long to make that move develop, that Vader bomb-like maneuver. Ecstasy knew it was coming and bought himself just a little bit of daylight.
Well, if he would have hit it, the complexion of this whole match would have changed dramatically. He missed it, though, desperately trying to tag in the fresh partner.
Definitely so. Oh, and there it is again. Big time. Big time super kick planted on the face of Lockjaw. And what does it feel like to take not one, but two of those in a 10-minute span?
It's a tough move to take even for a big man like Lockjaw. Cobweb's definitely in the head, trying desperately to get over to get the fresh man, Black Assassin, in the ring.
Well, Ecstasy normally would go for a pin there, normally would take the guy out. However, he knows that Black Assassin lingering at ringside is going to stick his nose in and make sure that he doesn't get the three count. So now he's thinking top rope, maybe for more punishment. I'm not sure. He's feeling the effects of earlier punishment.
Perched up top.
Oh, clean as hell. Moonsault. And just what I alluded to earlier, despite the big move, despite the would-be finisher, Black Assassin still took a right hand to the face. But before that, he broke up that three count, and now that mystery man at ringside shouting things into the ear of Black Assassin.
You called it. In this type of match, you've got to take down both men if you want to get a 1-2-3 in a handicap match.
Well, definitely so. Ecstasy, see, he's distracted. Despite the right hands on Lockjaw, sends him outside the ring. He was looking at Black Assassin the entire time to try to read what he was going to do next. Oh, beautiful moonsault. However, in this type of matchup, it's not going to get you a three count. Ecstasy knew that, thought he'd go for it anyways. And now I believe Black Assassin, once again, the legal man.
Here we go, the fresh Black Assassin. Call timeout.
Come on.
Time out, Jacoby.
Yeah, that's about as sincere as, I don't know, Tiger Woods' apology.
I mean, come on, Ecstasy was born at night, but it wasn't last night.
Oh. Well, now they're just going toe-to-toe. It's broken down into nothing more than a glorified street fight with right hands exchanged by both men. It's like a night over at the Stagger Inn in Rancho before they closed it.
Rough place. Bang.
Nice suplex, pops the hips, does the Black Assassin, wants to tag in Lockjaw. There we go.
The quick tags, the fresh men, this is very smart.
I think I heard them say something to each other.
Get a tandem move going.
This might be the move they need to finally put away Ecstasy. It's been a valiant effort, but come on. It's 2-on-1, thanks to you.
You're damn right. Here's where the fireworks start, Jacoby Jones, beginning of the end.
Wade, he got out of it. Oh! Joe KO! Joe KO!
Damn!
Super kick!
No! No! Damn it!
Wow!
I gotta go, hold on.
Well, Ecstasy plucks him out of midair with the amazing Joe KO. Black Assassin soared off the top rope, and Ecstasy got him with the Joe KO. A super kick on Lockjaw later, and Ecstasy just defied the odds and electrified hundreds in attendance and thousands watching at home. What an effort. Baseball biceps paid off tonight. Wait. Oh, it's Joey Balls. And a very bitter Joey Balls and Dick Pearsall are going to town on Ecstasy. After enduring a 20-minute handicap match battle with two very powerful men taking all their best moves, oh, Joey Balls and Dick Pearsall are out here like cowards to... Come on. We're out here to suck the carcass dry. Joey Balls trying to take out Ecstasy before they meet at the live show this Saturday at the Colonial Theater. Oh, wait. Oh. And now stretching him out. Look at Dick Pearsall get some cheap shots in. Yeah, the kings of the cheap shots.
Who are you? I am.
And I'm not sure what that was that Dick Pearsall just slammed into the face of Ecstasy with his fist, but it obviously has knocked him out. Despicable, cowardly actions by those two right there. Look at this. Backflips his way out of trouble. Plucks him out of midair with the Joe KO. A super kick across the jaw of Lockjaw. And a three count later, an Ecstasy defied every odd in the damn house. But the proceedings were not over. Joey Balls, Sneak Attack, Pearl Harbor, Dry Gulch, whatever you want to call it, him and Dick Pearsall go after Ecstasy and take him out. Oh, dip like a chip. And then stretches him out, and then Dick Pearsall, I don't know if those are brass knuckles, I don't know what the hell that was, but it knocked Ecstasy out. Finally, Ecstasy, several minutes later, is coming to. This is not over by a long shot. I guarantee you that. That man right there will be at the Colonial Theater on July 17th, this Saturday, looking for revenge against Joey Balls. You had better show up live to see him get what Joey Balls deserves. There it is right there. Oh, I hope you're proud of yourself, Dick.
Let that be a lesson to everybody out there. Don't cross the militia.
Yeah, well, July 17th, this Saturday, you're going to get yours. Colonial Theater, 3522 Stockton Boulevard in Sacktown, door 7, bell time 7:30. You better watch your back.
Oh, here. That was absolutely a thing of beauty, and believe me, Ecstasy is thinking twice.
Well, the Jake loses a number one contender match, but somehow, some way, ends up with a title shot against Pauly Denali, a.k.a. Anthrax, this Saturday, a rematch of Rio Mania's epicness. Wow.
The Jake is like David Blaine. He's a magician. He just pulls it out of a hat.
Also, what we just talked about, Joey Balls just destroyed Ecstasy, but he didn't finish the job. Ecstasy goes for revenge this Saturday, Colonial Theater at Revengeance.
I hope Ecstasy's looking over his shoulder. He has a third eye in the back of his head because he is a marked man.
Oh, really?
Damn right.
Well, Sick Case and Scorpion have been going at it tooth and nail for months. Finally, they meet one-on-one this Saturday. Revengeance. I can't wait.
Not for the faint of heart. Not for the squeamish. Turn the children away from the television set because this one's going to be crazy.
Also, Raz Rhino finally one-on-one with Ron Rufio after that handicap gauntlet debacle we saw several weeks ago. Raz and Ron one-on-one grudge match central at Revengeance.
Two of the most charismatic wrestlers in TWF locking horns.
Well, you see the television times on the screen right there. Sacramento, Davis, Stockton area. We're also on in West Sacramento, Fridays and Saturdays, 10 p.m., Channel 21 on, I believe it's Charter Cable out there.
There you go.
Maybe they changed it to Wave Cable. I don't know. Whatever the case may be, spread the word to friends and family. We are on television screens all over this great state.
French camp. Oh, where else are we?
Also, you can watch full TV shows whenever you want. TWFWrestling.net, YouTube, MySpace, Facebook, Twitter, all covered. Plus, call or text the TWF hotline. It's a cell phone. 916-370-8931 whenever you feel like it.
With all those burning questions we know that you have about the TWF, yeah, give the number a call and ask the questions, and guess what? They might get answered.
Finally, the herbs come around me.
If you currently use Nature's Medicine but don't have a medical card, what are you waiting for? It's never been easier or cheaper to get a legal medical card. Free yourself from stress and worry. Open yourself up to a whole new world of ease, convenience, and variety. Call the folks at Lotus Mountain and they'll help you get started. And if you currently have a legal prescription, give Lotus Mountain a call for great strain selection, great prices, and they deliver. Free gift to first-time buyers. 916-410-1874. That's 916-410-1874. Lotus Mountain, they bring nature's medicine to you.
Oh, I've been waiting for this for months. Steel Johnson and Carney Craig, by virtue of last month's show, earned a tag title opportunity against Ashton and Inc., and guess what? It's happening now.
This is the main event for tonight, and worthy of a main event anywhere. It's going to be good.
Tag titles will be contested. A very illustrious history for those particular championships. It's put up or shut up time for both teams. Those men right there have gone through hell and back to earn this opportunity at Tag Team Gold. However, despite their charisma, despite their ability, no Famous Inc. has something up their sleeves. But can these Venture Brothers shake and bake their way to a tag title? I don't know. What I do know is both teams have supporters at ringside.
Hey, seriously, if he gets his mom, hey, if Ashton's mom gets in the ring,
as
he
Vortex
drops
discusses that's strategy that's with Steel Johnson, as we await the arrival of the defending champions. The kings of the tag team scene.
Kobe, it's a simple case of the haves versus the have-nots. Famous Inc. was born with silver spoons in their mouth. They've gotten everything they've ever wanted their entire life. The opposite end of the spectrum is the Venture Brothers. I said it. Wow.
Yeah, it's the rich kids from Elk Grove versus the blue-collar heroes from North Sac.
Take a look at Famous Inc., because that's what winners look like.
Well, these two have met for the tag titles before. In that last contest, it was Famous Inc. who came out of it with the gold, who retained the gold. However, since that time, Carney Craig and Steel Johnson have shown a ton of character and a ton of heart to work their way back up the ladder and earn this rematch here tonight, main event on TV.
Let's see if it ends up in futility or if they're able to gain that gold back.
Well, there's a reason Famous Inc. has been tag champions for many months. Controversy or not, they find a way to outsmart everyone. Oh. Oh, double slaps on both ends, and you don't think that Steel and Craig are going to take that sitting down. Steel Johnson shoved outside the ring by Ashton. Uh-oh.
A little quick humiliation and now a quick two-on-one action. And look at this. Carney Craig's absolutely getting taken to task.
Well, the muscle with the hustle. And the cocky cover boy doing their best early to hit something big.
Very quick tandem offense. Oh, wow.
And only a minute and a half into this thing, Steel Johnson on the outside. Carney Craig gets leveled.
Amazing.
And the foot's on the bottom rope. But a big move like that definitely moves the gauges in the direction of Famous Inc.
Hell yeah, it's like someone hitting a leadoff home run in a baseball game. Right out of the gates, they absolutely destroy Carney Craig with a tandem offense move. awesome.
Definitely so. How many times did Ricky Henderson hit a leadoff home run to start a game that shifted the momentum in his team's direction? It's like Craig and Steele got to play catch-up now, but he's doing a good job. Shoulder butts to the stomach now, and Carney Craig.
Here he goes. Nobody home.
Oh, nobody home. Missed the pool. Neck breaker by Ink, and you got to think Carney Craig was still a little woozy from that taking that big double team move early on, and now Ink once again has regained that momentum for Famous Ink.
Damn right, caused him to make a little bit of a miscalculation on an offensive move, and now look at him, he's behind the eight ball again.
Well, Carney Craig has the heart the size of this damn room. However, Ink has a fist the size of this damn room. He's a big man, and he will use every opportunity to take out Craig when it shows itself.
Damn right, started out as a bodyguard.
Here we go. Reversal. Oh, nicely done. Flips forward with the cutter-like maneuver. Some people call that diamond dust. Pinfall attempt. Not quite get the job done. However, Carney Craig found a way, like he always does, to turn a negative into a positive. Now he needs to make that tag, and very smart by doing that.
Impressive offensive move by Carney Craig, the ringmaster, gets his partner, Steele Johnson, in the match.
Here we go. We saw Famous Ink, Ashton and Ink, with their double team early. Now it's time for these Venture Brothers to do it. Nice double suplex to take advantage of that momentum, and Steele Johnson is legal. Only a two count, but definitely swings things in the direction of the challengers.
Both of these teams are amazing at working tandem offense. Oh, guess what? Down south.
Well, Steele Johnson took his eyes off the prize for a split second, and Ink made him pay. Irish whip now.
Wow.
Big time clothesline, and down he goes. And Ink tags in the former TWF champion, the cocky cover boy, the verbal leader of Famous Ink.
You're damn right.
And now squeezing on the arm. Oh.
Now you want to talk about some pretty tandem offense. How about that?
Well, Steele Johnson kicks out, but just barely. But gets wrapped around in a pretzel and then takes a knee from each man right in the damn spine. Steele Johnson clutching his ribs in pain. Ashton exploiting that at every second he can.
Meanwhile, you have the queen of TWF, beautiful Crystal, watching on.
Yeah, Crystal's on the outside. Crystal, you know she's going to stick her nose where it doesn't belong. However, you've got co-commissioner Vortex and Ron Rufio on the other side cheering on their best buds.
There's a lot of people on the outside of the ring for both these teams.
Thrown into the corner goes Ashton. Oh, a big meat hook of a clothesline, and Ashton is hurt.
Oh, I could watch this all day.
Very nicely executed by Famous Ink. Yes, they do their homework. Yes, they always come in with a great game plan. However, these people are just chomping at the bit to see Steele and Craig unseat the champions here tonight. I don't know, it could happen.
Well, to be the man, you gotta beat the man. It's the old saying, and right now, Famous Ink are the men.
Yeah, they're the men as far as the tag titles are concerned here in TWF. Oh, yeah, that's the point of the knee. That's not the top or the bottom or the back of the knee. That's the point of the knee after the tricky dance moves on the damn Temple of Steel. Oh, DDTs him on his damn skull. And Ashton, who uses every inch of that 6'5" frame better than just about anyone.
Oh, strong words by a strong woman.
Someone needs a bar of soap in her mouth.
Kids, cover your ears.
And I'm not talking about what you like to do in the bedroom, Dick Pearsall.
Hey now.
I'm talking about someone's got a potty mouth at ringside. And it ain't me.
She calls it like she sees it.
Obviously, the pressure of this matchup. Oh. Oh. We've seen Ink do that several times before, and it looks like it hurts every single time. Well, maybe, just maybe the pressure of this contest, the pressure of having those belts on the line is getting to Crystal. Oh, there's a slingshot splash by Ashton.
Very nice.
Carney Craig, though, was in there to make sure that there was absolutely, positively no possible three count on that situation. Steele Johnson, though, has been getting pummeled for several minutes now. Nicely done by Ashton.
Well, I can say these four guys wrestling each other has turned officially, in my eyes, into a blood feud.
Yeah, definitely. There's definitely bad blood here. We saw them meet in Woodland We saw Ink pick up a win over Carney Craig in singles competition on television a few weeks back. You got to think the post-match beatdown is still throbbing through the brains of Carney Craig and Steel Johnson.
Deep-seated hatred.
Oh, look at this. Couldn't be any more blatant.
What?
Hello? Oh.
How about that? And the ref didn't see a thing.
Oh, and now the referee is getting caught. Come on. The shenanigans were on the other side of the ring, referee Christian Black.
Good stuff.
I tell you. Well, meanwhile, though, Steel Johnson on his knees. His face, his body, his spine has got to be throbbing in pain from these many, many minutes of punishment. Oh, a kick right to the damn stomach.
Famous Ink is absolutely diabolically, systematically tearing apart Steel Johnson.
Well, we all know that Ashton is a sucker for the details, and so is Ink. So they came in with a definite game plan, and they've been executing it to near perfection. But however, Steel Johnson blocks the punch and is going after it.
One of the most vicious right hands in the business is Steel Johnson. Things like a damn meat hook. Oh, man.
He makes the tag. Oh, but Carney Craig didn't have much room. But here we go. Carney Craig. Carney Craig.
Ashton tried to stop that tag, but it didn't happen. Now Carney Craig with a head of steam.
Takes him out. Nicely done. I think he calls that the Catalina wine mixer. And it just mixed the brain of Ashton all up in his skull.
Right now, the champs are taking 5-minute respite to try to get the game plan back in order.
Well, there you go, though. Once they start to lose that offensive edge, you see Famous Ink hightail it outside the ring so it doesn't continue. Steel Johnson knows that and goes after Ink with some big rights.
Huge right hands, now tossing them back into the squared circle.
Well, who's legal? I'm not sure who the legal man is. Referee Christian Black, I guess it's the two that are in the ring right now.
That's what he's calling, I guess.
Carney Craig, though, with a ton of momentum, sends him outside the ring.
That's where you do not want to be.
Now the referee's holding back Ashton. Wait.
He's up top. What?
Ashton throws caution to the wind and dives on everyone, Dick.
What a fantastic shot. The cocky cover boy takes everybody out.
While picking and choosing his high-risk spots and picked one at the absolute best time because it looks like Steel and Carney Craig definitely got the worst of that.
Ashton's still feeling the effects of that move, though.
Well, the action is spilled on the outside. Oh, no.
Here we go.
Oh! The already injured spine of Steel just crashed into the Colonial floor with that double suplex.
Unforgiving concrete.
See Ink clutching his lower back as well. This, my friends, is a war for the TWF Tag Team titles.
Hell yeah, there's a lot on the line here. Oh, wait a minute.
Carney Craig, out of nowhere, moonsaults onto both of his opponents and takes them both out at their own gate.
I didn't see the fallen wrestler sign. Man.
And just when you think the Venture Brothers can't take anymore, just when you think they're out of the equation, Carney Craig throws caution to the wind, backflips onto both his opponents, and definitely swings things back towards these Venture Brothers.
You heard it, Carney Craig, look for something.
Months of training, months of preparation, months of working their way up the ladder. And you see Ashton fly off the top one more time. There's that snap suplex. Oh,
man, bone jarring.
And Carney Craig has a steel chair.
With bad intentions.
Ashton, I believe he threw Steel into the ring. On the top there, the top of your screen.
Action's fast and furious.
However, Carney Craig has Ink, and he's taking him up the aisle. Here we go. The floor cameraman capturing everything.
Trying his best to. On the ring.
Ashton plants an elbow. Oh my. However, Carney Craig just got upended. His efforts got thwarted by Ink moments ago. Don't break the damn chairs of the Colonial, guys.
And how many times you see it, you bring a weapon out and it gets used against you. Oh no.
Ribs first across that steel chair.
What does that feel like?
And Carney Craig's efforts at a big high risk, crazy move just backfired on him big time.
Kodak moment.
Oh, right to the face, and look at that.
Oh, my.
The chair was bent up like a damn pretzel, and it's all on Carney Craig's ribs.
Oh. That could be a cracked rib. That could be some internal damage. I don't know if Carney Craig's going to bounce back from that move.
A toss back in the ring by Ankus C there. That could be a difference maker right there. If Carney Craig has broken ribs, all their chances of winning the title are out the damn window, Dick Pearsall.
Hell yeah, look at him right now.
He can barely stand. Only with a guy holding him up can Carney Craig stand at this particular moment. This is not good if you're a fan of Carney Craig. Oh, wait.
What the hell?
Well, sometimes adrenaline can be your best friend. Carney Craig going after Ashton with everything he's got.
Where the hell is Carney Craig getting this from? He was practically dead. Now look at him. He's cleaning house like who?
Alice from the Brady Bunch, to date myself just a little bit.
Good Lord.
And now, Carney Craig on one side, Steel Johnson on the other. Big time rights to the face, and can you feel it, Dick Pearsall? Oh, wait. Damn it. Damn it. Steel Johnson gets shoved to the outside, and once again, Famous Inc. has a way to stop them in their tracks.
I was about to say, Mr. Momentum has a new address, and it's called the Challengers, but no longer.
Steel Johnson is on the outside. Craig's in a tough position. Oh, and puts a couple knees into his spine once again.
Fantastic, but wait a minute.
Oh, but Steel Johnson's in.
No one saw Steel Johnson getting in the ring.
He just sent Ink the hard way to the outside. Oh, DDT's Ashton right on his damn skull.
Advantage, Venture Brothers.
Uh-oh. Suplex, perhaps.
Setting something up.
Oh,
my God. Not again.
I smell something burning.
Oh.
Two.
They did it. New tag team champions. Ladies and gentlemen, we have brand new tag team champions.
Good Lord, what a match.
Steel Johnson and Carney Craig have done it. They have beat Famous Inc. at their own game and taken home the gold.
Absolutely epic match and a changing of the guard.
Back and forth and back and forth, but when it's all said and done, it was this right here, kaboom, that won them the titles. Oh, wait.
A second time with authority.
Oh, dumped on his skull for a second time. It was over.
Wow.
A genuinely awesome moment here at the Colonial Theater in Sacramento, California. Those men right there are tag team champions of this company.
What do they say, every once in a while a blind squirrel can find a nut? Well, there you go, boys. Enjoy your nut.
Yeah, right. They were the better team on this night, and you know it, Dick.
Well, the heavy hitters are partying tonight.
Definitely so. Boats and hoes for everyone. Well, this Saturday, you can see them make their first title defense. Awesome. You got to show up. July 17th, Colonial Theater, 3522 Stockton Boulevard in Sacktown, door 7, bell time 7:30. You got to show up. It'll be the event of the summer.
You're damn right. We know you're out there watching it. We know we're the highest rated show on this channel. So what we need to do is get your butts at the Colonial Theater watching the live shows. Why?
For the title, the Jake has somehow, someway weaseled his way into a title match with the champion, Paulie Denali, a.k.a. Anthrax. It'll be awesome.
You're damn right. And if you want to call a feud a blood feud, this would live up to that billing faux show.
Also, we saw the shenanigans from earlier. We saw the sneak attack from Joey Balls. Him and Ecstasy duke it out one-on-one for the first time ever this Saturday, Colonial Theater, Revengeance.
We know every single person in that audience is going to be rooting for Joey Balls to give Ecstasy his comeuppance. Well, here it comes.
Sick Case and Scorpion have been duking it out for many years here in TWF. Finally, they meet one-on-one this Saturday at Revengeance. Expect it to be a war.
Anybody who's seen these two lock it up in the past know what you're in for. You don't want to miss that one.
Also, Raz Rhino and Ron Rufio had an epically crazy Samoan chain match at Real Mania. You get to see them do it again one-on-one.
100,000 Rufaholics are going to be going absolutely crazy, cheering on their hyphy guy, and who knows, maybe he'll be able to pull it off.
Well, thank you so much for watching TWF. We're at the Colonial Theater this Saturday. Thank you so much to Too Good Productions. Amazing television production work, as always. And go to TWFWrestling.net to watch full 60-minute shows. Get the skinny on everything. Of course, we're on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, MySpace, all that.
And you want to be cool? Buy a TWF t-shirt. It'll make you 10% cooler than anybody you know.
We have white t-shirts. We have plenty. We will see you this Saturday.